Hi everyone, my name is Bumi Adeleye. Every week, I will be going on a journey around our wonderful country, Nigeria. And I want to invite you on what will be a culinary delight as we taste the food of Nigeria, the way we prepare it, cook it, and enjoy it. On our journey, we will travel together to some wonderful cities, towns, and places around this great and diverse country of ours. It is a journey I look forward to, and on which I hope you will join me as we meet new people like you, join them in their happy homes as they share the way they cook and prepare their favorite foods. Come along with me as we explore Nigeria right here on Delicious Naija, brought to you by Maggie.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredients that makes a happy home.
Maggie's Star, made from natural soya beans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie's Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good life.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredients that makes a happy home.
Maggie's Star. Made from natural soya beans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good life.
Today, we are in IBADAN, the city that is at the edge of the savannah. By the way, that is literally the meaning of IBADAN, the capital of Oyo State. Magbo Hall is one of the most recognizable edifices in IBADAN. It is actually right in the middle of ancient IBADAN. I am told that it is the place where the community used to meet to discuss issues and settle matters. Today, Magbo Hall is still relevant and represents the heritage and culture that Ibadan people are so proud of. You know, when you're in a new city, the first thing you want to do is explore, and that is what I'm off to do. Now, one of the ways to discover the flavor of a new city is to speak to one of the locals. I'm on my way to visit someone to whom IBADAN means a whole lot. He's gonna share with me about the people and about their way of life. Come, let's go. Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Welcome.
Thank you so much.
How are you?
Very good.
I hope you didn't find it difficult to get here.
No, not at all. This place is amazing.
All right.
I didn't even realize that Ibadan has such...
Well, wow. Ibadan city is a combination of old and new school.
As in, I could actually just pose here and I'll say, selfie in Dublin. That's not something Although you just take care not to have that agodi something in the background. But if I take a picture here, man, I'm easily...
It's okay. It is. Well, I'm from Oyo State. To be specific, I am from Isei.
Isei. Tell me about the Ibadan people. Who is the Ibadan man?
An average Ibadan man is peaceful, very peaceful, very accommodating,
really?
Very generous. One important thing in Ibadan is that it's a very stable food here in Ibadan.
Okay.
It's amala.
Correct.
Amala. As a matter of fact, if you come to Ibadan and you stay 1 year and you don't taste amala in Ibadan, then you have not come to Ibadan. I want to stamp your coming to Ibadan.
On the passport.
On the, let me take you to one place now. And you eat amala. Hello, Sajenwa. This is my friend. She's coming to Ibadan for the first time.
You are welcome.
And then I want her to know that she has actually come to Ibadan.
That's nice.
And fair amala, gidi amala Ibadan.
Amala to bono to fele to you know.
Don't
forget.
Don't forget.
And
where I want to shaki ganka ye. I didn't want it to be cold.
You're a good man,
They say that the taste of the pudding, or in this case, jamala, is beauty. Ewa jam.
Eyan, ewa jam.
Jamala is important.
Now,
it's important.
Welcome to Ibadan.
Thank you very much. Something else.
All right,
something else. Thank you so very much for bringing me here. It was
pleasure.
An experience. I enjoyed myself. Thank you so
nice
very
day.
Much. I will.
All right,
I will.
Now.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye. Have a good day.
Yeah, you.
So, I just had the most amazing bowl of amala. It was nice. It was all fele go. It was very, very nice. And I enjoyed it. I've met beautiful people. I've had an amazing meal. But my trip to Ibadan will not be complete until I have made a traditional indigenous Yoruba dish. Luckily for me, I have a family who have invited me in. That's what I'll be doing tomorrow. I'll find out what I'm making when I get there. Don't go nowhere.
My name is Mrs. Obagunwa Grace.
My name is Obagunwa Joseph Saturday.
I'm a teacher. Presently, I'm the head of a school.
I operate the cleaning service and also a pastor.
Then we are blessed with 3 kids, 3 wonderful daughters.
My wife is so nice, so caring, so jovial. She's my friend. Just like a mother, she's a wife, she's a friend.
Being a woman, you have to be on your feet. You have to be able to combine being a pastor's wife, being a mother, being a teacher, and being a wife to your husband. You have to do everything. Then, what do I have to do? You wake up early at the right time, take care of your children, prepare what they need to eat, then what they'll pack to school as well.
My favorite is anything to swallow, okele.
Wow, my husband can cook very well. In fact, he's a cook. There is no dish he cannot prepare. Yoruba people, I will say this adage, only anoburuku osheni, chumoko buruku oshison. If you are not in good relationship with your in-law, it will really affect the family negatively. It will. But my in-laws are wonderful. You see how you know it's a one big family. My mother-in-law is my mother. Well, I invited Bumi to my house to learn how to cook this ishakpa soup, this indigenous soup, which I learned from my mother-in-law. So I'd like to pass it on to her too. My time with Bumi today is going to be fun. We're going to catch fun, and it is going to be educative.
So, I am here to meet our star of the week. Her name is Grace Obagunwa, but her friends call her Gigi. She's dedicating today's meal to a woman who is special and important to her, her mother-in-law. Let's go see if we can help.
I'm fine.
Please come
and meet
me.
Very good.
You're welcome.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Hello, sweeties.
This is mommy's
Gigi.
Yeah.
Tell me, what are we making today?
Oh, I'm making a nice, delicious food. I'm making pounded yam with shakpa soup. Ishakpa soup.
Yes.
Yes, so.
Okay, I have never heard of ishakpa soup.
That's why I said I'm not sure you've tasted it.
Never ever. I came hungry to eat your special dish today. So now that I've heard it's ishakpa and pounded yam, let's go and buy some.
Ah, we are going right away. This is Bodija Market.
Okay.
So we are here to buy our things. So yeah, I want to buy fish. How much be this one?
This one, 700 naira.
So how can you tell that your fish is fresh?
You smell through the mouth with your nose.
Okay.
Then you get to know if it has rotten in or not. Because you can't know by seeing it. Yes. So put out for 900. I just like the fish. This tomato I want to add. Some people doesn't like to add tomato because of the sour taste of it.
Oh,
yes, I but I prefer adding little. But the problem now is how to preserve the tomatoes after putting the little which I want. Mama, they need to kekere for me.
You know what? Just get what you need.
Okay.
I'll show you how to preserve your tomatoes for 6 months up to 1 year. So just get what you need. You use what you need for the ishakpa and we'll preserve the rest.
Ah,
6 months to 1 year.
Mama, eba mi gasi lailon, eba mi ko, eba mi ko. Ishakpa.
This is ishakpa.
Benny.
This is the one I know.
This one is
the red one.
Zobo.
This is the one we used to make the drink. Wow.
Then you need to check.
What am I looking for?
You make sure there is no mold on it.
Okay.
And that it is fresh and clean. It must be very fresh too. And dry.
And dry.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredients that makes a happy home.
Maggie's Star, made from natural soya beans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie's Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good life.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredients that makes a happy home.
Maggie's Star. Made from natural soya beans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good life.
Great. Now it's time to cook. Here is the ishakpa.
Oh yes.
Let's look at it properly. Can you see it?
Tray.
You need to pour it in a bowl because you need to soak it with hot water. Here is the egusi. So the first step we'll take is we'll roast the egusi first.
Why are we roasting egusi?
It brings out aroma. So
this has to dry first though.
Yes. Then you need to stir it occasionally so that everything doesn't pop out of the frying pan. Okay.
This is ready now.
Yes. So I need to wash my fish now. Before I'll add water to it, I'll use salt to scrub it to remove the germs. The salt is already changing color, bringing out the dirty.
So now that our water is boiling, we need to pour water inside it. So we need to pour water, hot water in our ishakpa too, to make it soft. And then also to remove the sour taste. And it is going to stay for 20 minutes.
Okay.
Let's get other ingredients ready for our cooking. Now all our ingredients are ready. I'll put my palm oil.
Okay.
To add our pepper.
Ooh.
I can have my locust beans now. And locust beans is very good.
It's actually
body.
Quite nice.
Very, very good.
It is. But I realize it's an acquired taste.
So the next thing we are to add our meats. Fish. One more now. So I need a little bit of water. Thank you. So here, Oba Irawo.
Maggie crayfish.
In fact, nobody can look at my husband because he will not even look at the person. So, we cover it for some minutes to cook thoroughly.
Okay.
Then while that is cooking, let's tear, we need to add water.
Okay,
to
this.
Yes,
so make a paste.
So, I'll add 2 tablespoons of my crayfish. Then I'll put in my melon. You can use spoon, it's no problem, but I prefer using hand so that the balls can be formed.
So can I cover it now?
Yes, cover it. So we are going to cook for the next 20 minutes. Then we add our ishakpa, then the food is done.
Okay, so while we're waiting for this to cook,
okay,
I'm going to show you that thing I told you about preserving tomatoes.
Yeah.
In the meantime, let's clean up.
Okay.
Here are some of the tomatoes we got from the market.
Okay.
The first thing you want to do is get the jar. That's the jar I got. And you want to sterilize it. You open it like so. Okay. And immerse it inside hot boiling water.
Okay.
For about an hour, 40 minutes to an hour. Now, the next thing that you do is get the juice of a lemon. I've juiced it already here.
Okay.
Okay, taking out the seeds. And you put in, you take your jar.
Okay.
You put in 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, and then you take 1 teaspoon of salt, put it in, and then you take your washed tomatoes, and you start to put it inside the jar. And you make sure that the tomatoes are not bruised or broken, just fresh. The next thing for us to get boiling water. We want it about 3/4 full. Brilliant. Now it covers all the tomatoes, but there is still some space left in the jar for the tomatoes to breathe. And now I will cover it like so and seal it. There, it's sealed. If you find that there are bubbles before you seal it, then you take your spoon and take the back of the spoon and push it down.
Okay, to fill the space.
Just to push it forward to make sure that there are no air bubbles, but can't have any air bubbles in it. So the next thing you do is give it a water bath.
Okay.
And then you cover and leave it to boil for 40 minutes to an hour again. Yes, and once that is boiled, you take it out.
Okay.
And you set it aside, let it cool.
Okay.
Once it's cooled, you can put it in your store, cool, dry place in your store, in your cupboard.
Okay.
And in that store, in that cupboard, it can keep for up to 6 months, for between 6 months.
The tomato in it?
Yes,
wow,
between 6 months to a year. When you're ready to use it and you open it,
Okay.
Once you've broken that seal, you must either use up all the tomatoes in the jar or whatever is left, you put it in the fridge.
Okay, now let's check.
Okay.
Ishapada, please pass it to me. I can't wait.
Wow, it seems I had my name now. That's grandma.
Grandma, I can't believe it. Yes, ma'am. Grandma, we are going to surprise you because I'm cooking your special dish. Your special delicacy. Yes, I'm sure it is ready now.
Okay.
Okay. Wow. Oh. This is great.
You learned this one very well.
Yes. Now, the onion is ready.
Say delicious Naija.
Delicious.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredients that makes a happy home.
Maggie Star. Made from natural soya beans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good life.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredients that makes a happy home.
Maggie Star, made from natural soya beans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good life.
Hey, man. I'm you.
This
is the best soup I've ever tasted.
Especially because your wife made it.
Exactly.
Yes, so.
The really shakwa just comes together with the juicy and everything is just tasting amazing. Let me ask you, I mean, it's been amazing cooking with your wife in the kitchen, learning how to make ishapa soup. But one thing that stands out is how joyful she is. She's so happy. She always sings and, you know, just has a way around doing her thing. She's very happy. And there you have it. Another happy family, another delicious recipe, but most importantly, a happy and satisfied mother-in-law. You can only get this right here on Delicious Naija, brought to you by Maggie. Food is really the strength of life. Good food, a divine blessing. The city of Ibadan is a vibrant hub for delicious Western delicacies. I am standing in front of the famous Cocoa House, once the tallest building in Nigeria, and built from the proceeds of cocoa. I would like to thank the Obagunwas for a delicious experience. Until I come your way again from another delicious part of Niger, my name is Bumi Adelaye, and this is me signing out for Delicious Niger, brought to you by Maggie.
For more information on how to prepare ishapa soup, follow us on Instagram @Maggie_Nigeria and on Facebook or YouTube at Maggie, Nigeria.
Nestle, good food, good life.